गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
क्लास 11th, गुड मॉर्निंग. सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर एंड नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज
मोशन इन स्ट्रेट लाइन. मोशन इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन.
सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव टू स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर मोशन इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन. सो वट इज़ द मीनिंग ऑफ मोशन? सो स्टूडेंट्स, इफ आ ऑब्जेक्ट इज चेंजिंग इट्स पोजिशन विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू टाइम, देन द ऑब्जेक्ट इज सेट टू बी इन मोशन. सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव टू स्टडी मैकेनिक्स इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर. सो वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विद दैट मैकेनिक्स. What is the meaning of mechanics? So, if the object is in motion, if the object is in rest, the study of various cases of the object and the motion of the object around its surrounding is study under the branch of physics, and the name of that branch is mechanics. We can divide physics into various parts. So, in the part we will study about the motion of the object or the rest of the object around its surrounding is under the mechanics. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. There are few parts of mechanics which we are going to study. In the various first sub branch of mechanics is
statics. Second one is kinematics. And last is dynamics. So students,
there is difference between statics, kinematics and dynamics. In statics, we will study the object at rest only. If the object is at rest, that is under the statics. Now, second one is kinematics. If we are studying the motion of the object, and remember one thing, when we are studying about kinematics, we don't consider the cause of motion. Under the branch of this means kinematics, we are not going to discuss about what is the cause of motion. Means we are not going to discuss about various forces which are causing this kind of motion. And the third part is dynamics. So what is the meaning of dynamics? The meaning of dynamics is we will study the motion of the object and we will study the cause of the motion of the object. So this is under dynamics. I hope this is clear to you. And now we are going to start the next topic, and that is rest and motion.
Rest and motion. Students,
you are already familiar with these words as you have studied these in your class 9th. So what is rest? What is the meaning of that object is at rest? So students, if the object is not changing its position with respect to its surrounding, if the object will remain at fixed position with respect to time, with respect to its surrounding, then the object is said to be in rest. For example, right now I am at rest because I am not changing my position with respect to my surrounding. Okay. And if the object is changing its position continuously with respect to its surrounding, then the object is said to be in motion. These both the words are relative to each other, rest and motion. Okay. If the object is changing its position with respect to its surrounding, with respect to time, then the object is said to be in motion. So students, there are two words which I am going to discuss right now, is absolute rest and absolute motion.
Absolute rest and absolute motion.
So students, let me tell you, you must be familiar with these words, absolute rest, absolute motion. Both are not possible. It is not possible that the object will be at absolute rest. Absolute means with respect to every frame, right? Like we use the word, you are absolutely right. Absolutely right means with all the aspects you are right. Absolute means with all the frames, with all the axes, with respect to all the axes, the object is at rest. So this is the condition which is never possible. Absolute rest is not defined. Why? For example, suppose I say I am at rest. So right now, for you people, I could be at rest. Okay. But at the same time, I am at motion because I am the part of earth. And earth is moving. And earth is moving with a very high velocity. And the velocity of earth is as high as this. This is difficult to calculate. Why this is difficult to calculate? Because earth is rotating on its own axis. What is the time period? The time period of earth's rotation around its own axis is 24 hours. And earth is revolving around sun. This is another motion of us because we are the part of earth. What is the time period? About the rotation of earth around sun, that is 365 whole 1 upon 4 days. This is our second motion. The third motion is that whole the planetary system is also moving. So this is our third motion. And the very fourth motion of us is that universe is also expanding. As we are the part of universe, so we are expanding. So universe is expanding, so this is our fourth motion. So even as I am declaring I am at rest, I am at the same time I am at a motion, and even the motion is this much greater, it is difficult to calculate. If you will calculate the average of this, this will be near about 65-70 kilometer per second. This is a very high velocity. If someone is riding the bike with 60-70 speed, then you will get a phone call to your father that someone is riding the bike with a very high velocity, with a very high speed. So we are not at absolute rest at any time. We are at motion all the time. So absolute rest is not possible. In the similar way, absolute motion is also not possible. Suppose we say that we are at motion, we are moving. For example, you are dropping your relative to railway station and that relative is now in the train. He is moving, the train is moving, you are saying bye-bye. He is in motion for you. Okay, but at the same time for the passengers, those who are in the train, that is in rest for them because his position is not changing for them. So absolute rest and absolute motion both are not defined, or it is not possible case in physics. Okay, I hope you understood this. Now rest and motion, absolute rest, absolute motion is clear. And now we are going to discuss about various kind of motion, means motion in one dimension, motion in two dimension, motion in three dimension. So let us discuss this.
One dimensional motion, two dimensional motion, then three dimensional motion.
So what is the meaning of one dimensional motion, two dimensional motion, or three dimensional motion?
So 1D means,
suppose one axis is enough to describe the motion of the body, then the motion of the body is said to be one dimensional. For example, suppose one body is moving in a straight line. It doesn't matter that which kind of straight line it is moving. Sometimes students get stuck. They say that only x-axis should be used. No, it could be any axis, and that is not fixed even that x-axis will be this only. Okay, you can consider it in anywhere. So suppose an object is moving in a straight line like this. Suppose an object is moving in a straight line in this way. So only one axis is required to define the position of the object at any instant of time. We don't need, this is one dimension motion. We don't need any other axis to define the motion. This, suppose one parallel axis we have taken to this, and this will be enough to describe the position of the object at any instant of time. So such kind of motion in which only one axis is enough to define or to describe the position of the object is said to be one dimensional motion. What is two-dimensional motion? If at least two axes are required to describe the motion of the object. For example, suppose we have a kind of insect, and that insect is moving like this, okay, in a straight line. So one axis is enough to describe the motion. Suppose that insect is now turning also, turning in this, turning this, turning this. Now one axis will be failure to describe its motion. We need now at least two axes to describe its position at any instant of time. So that is motion in two dimension, if two axes are required to describe the motion. Now what is three dimensional? Suppose that insect can fly also. Moving like this, and now this insect is flying as well. Now, will it be enough? Two dimensions will be enough to describe its motion? No. We will need at least the third coordinate to describe its motion. So this, such kind of motion is three-dimensional motion. So, now, what is this kind of system? One is x-axis, another one is y-axis. And z-axis is here. Actually, z-axis is not like this. Z-axis is coming outward or going inward, like this. Like coming towards this screen. This is the third axis, z-axis. But maybe now it must be clearly visible to you. So this is x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. Z-axis is like this. You can see x-axis and z-axis. What is the angle between x-axis and z-axis? That is 90 degree. What is the angle between y-axis and z-axis? That is 90 degree. What is the angle between x and y? 90. So you will find that all three axes are mutually perpendicular. In such kind of system in which all the three coordinates, all the three axes are mutually perpendicular to each other is known as orthogonal system. And this all we study under Cartesian plane. You will study these all in mathematics as well. So this was just introduction part of this. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. One dimensional motion, if the object is moving in a straight line, means only one axis will be required. Suppose an object is moving like this, only x axis will be enough. If object is going like this, only y axis will be enough. Okay, so this is one dimensional motion. Suppose an object is going like this and going like this and going like this, turning also. So we will require at least two planes. So that is two-dimensional motion, motion in two dimension. Now suppose that object is flying as well. So these two axes will not be enough to describe its position. Here and here, x and y are enough. But like this, if object is flying like this, then we need at least the third coordinate system. So this will be motion in three dimension or three-dimensional motion. Rest and motion are clear? Now students, we will study about point object.
Point object.
So, what is the meaning of point object? If the object is covering a distance which is much greater as compared to its own size. If the object is covering a distance which is much greater as compared to its own size, then the object is said to be point object. For example, suppose one train is standing on Kashmir and it is going from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. Okay, so the distance covered by that particular train is much greater as compared to its own size. Okay, so this is known as point object. Now,
so this is point object concept, and then students,
we will discuss about uniform motion and non-uniform motion. So what is uniform motion, what is non-uniform motion? So if an object is covering equal distance in equal interval of time, that is said to be uniform motion. If an object is covering unequal distance in equal interval of time, then it is said to be non-uniform motion. Okay, I hope these are clear to you. So this is going to be enough for today. We will make more lectures and make you aware about that. So thank you. God bless you.